Hello and welcome. We are here to play Thimbleweed Park today.
We are.
And by we, I mean me, Hayden Dingman, and my co-host, Adam Patrick Murray.
Hello.
And yeah, we're just going to start a new game off. This is a Kickstarter game from, I don't know, 2 or 3 years ago. It is Ron Gilbert and co making a Ron Gilbert style.
Wait, who's that?
He worked on Maniac Mansion and a bunch of other classic 90s adventure games, as well as some newer stuff like The Cave. But yeah, this is, as you can tell from this little tutorial here, a very 90s adventure game.
I mean, and are they assuming you've played point and click adventure games, or is this like, this is for the diehard fans?
I think this is probably for diehard fans, yeah. But, I think this game is hilarious. I'll start by saying that. So I think if you hadn't played older adventure games, you would still get a lot of enjoyment out of this. But yeah, I think in general, probably diehard fans will get the most out of it.
All right.
It's definitely like in that 90s scum style, including like the verb block in the corner and stuff.
So what was this made in, do you know?
It's his own engine. He programmed his own adventure game engine.
All right.
In order to recreate, like, he didn't want to actually use scum, and he didn't want to use like any of the modern like adventure game studio. So he made his own proprietary engine. I talked to him last year, I think at like E3 or PAX, about whether he would think about licensing this once the game is out. And he said, yeah, maybe. So
how does it run? I mean, we're obviously running on pretty powerful hardware here, but
runs probably much better than needs to on this hardware. I would estimate we're getting like a million frames a second on the 2 1080Is in that Falcon box over there.
It does look pretty nice.
But yeah, so there's a lot of improvements over the actual scum engine, like a lot the background scrolls a lot nicer, and you get some parallax and stuff like that. And we're just starting a new game, so basically we're in the town of Thimbleweed Park, and this man is coming down to a secret location, and he will in short term be murdered. So
spoilers.
For some Wiener Schnitzel after the long walk out here.
Pause real quick. I'm gonna shut the door.
I am gonna turn on subtitles because I thought they were already on.
Text and speech?
Yeah, that would probably be it. Yes.
There we go.
I do want to mention real quick that this does have the best option in any game ever, which is a toilet paper over option.
Okay. And
because he originally did the art and the toilet paper was underneath.
Oh.
And people complained. So now you can swap it.
But you know, that seems like an appropriate reaction to the internet.
But yeah, so in very 90s adventure game form, the way that you play this game is you click on a verb and then click on the object that you want to use. So open gate. However, he also has shortcuts in here. So the Q, W, E, A, S, D, Z, X, C keys all correspond to the 9 verbs that you have.
Oh, nice.
So we can also just like move around and I can hit the X key for talk to. And we can chat with this homeless man down here. I am supposed to meet
someone down here. What is this accent? I'm not recognizing this accent.
He's a German man.
Okay.
So I have to go. I'm sorry I cannot offer you a drink. You also have like a basic context system. So you'll notice if we move over him, we get a talk to command automatically. So it's not entirely like 90s point and clicks where you had to select a verb first to do anything.
Well, and you had to know which verb to hit.
Yeah, this one will at least like do some of the work for you. So like we can walk to light by hitting the left button right now, but you'll also notice that look at is highlighted down in the bottom left. And that's the right click command. So if we right click, he'll look at it automatically. Which works a lot better than, you know, having to always click on these verbs. But we're going to open up our note here to see what we're supposed to do. We have to turn off the light above this sign over here, which is this sign right here. And to do that, we are going to grab this rock and we are going to use that rock on the light.
Nice. So have you found any secret stuff, like something that's not highlighted, like you can go back and like pick up the bum?
So there are a bunch of like weird bum things that we can do in this, or at least there are jokes about it. So like you can, you know, offer to give, especially once we get out of this prologue, there's a ton of items to pick up. And so you can like offer to give an empty bottle to people and stuff. And there are occasionally some really good responses.
Yeah. Nice.
And there's been a little bit of pixel hunting. So I found later on in the game, there's like a chainsaw in this like big wilderness area. And I found it just like by accident as I was walking through here, I like moused over it. So there's been a little bit of that, but it's nowhere near as bad as like an actual 90s point and click, which
nice.
I felt like the whole entire game was pixel hunting sometimes.
I never played too many point-and-click adventure games when I was younger. I did not have the patience for them.
But yeah, so now we're dead. That's the prologue. And now we are going to see our actual main characters, which is we have two federal agents, Agent Ray and Agent Reyes.
Okay.
And they have both come to Thimbleweed Park for apparently not very good reasons. But while they're here, they're going to investigate this body. So. Huh.
Have you beaten this game?
No, I'm like 5 hours into it so far.
Okay.
This is like about a week before the review embargo. So, we've got Ray on the left and Reyes on the right. And obviously our body in the middle.
So tell me again why you're here.
I was assigned to the case by the Home Office in Albuquerque.
Once again, these accents.
Yeah. his very good.
It's neat to know.
Do you know how big the team was that worked on this?
I don't. It's not very big.
I can imagine.
Maybe like 10, 15 people. I'm not sure.
And how successful was the Kickstarter?
Successful as far as like 2014, 2015 Kickstarters go.
But like, were they able to go pretty far past their
goal?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure they did. Because I don't know. It's been a while since I looked at that Kickstarter.
Mm-hmm.
I think they got about double their goal, maybe, but maybe not.
And are they self-publishing, or is this published by somebody?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, okay.
And the body is starting to pixelate, so we're going to take some pictures.
A camera. Look at that one step.
So we have a Polaroid camera.
Nice. I'm a Polaroid nerd, so that makes me very excited.
So we actually control both these characters, but independently, so we can swap between characters up here. And that is useful because they have different items, so we can give our Polaroid camera to Ray. And she'll be real upset, but she has the film, so we use our film in the camera.
Nice.
And then use our camera on the corpse. And
she got a sweet cell phone there too.
Yeah, and we get a good line here because now we can head into town and find the local sheriff. It's a good photo of the body. I like how the state-of-the-art camera captured the angle of the shot. Because we have a nice side shot of our body, even though she took it from over here. So
also that is not the right ratio of the film. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's not there's no developer room for the developer in there. It's okay. It's a video game. I can be okay with that.
I don't know if you can. I sound really upset.
Why is that little thing wiggling?
So that's our notebook. So this is our to-do list, basically. It's pretty slim right now because we're basically just going into town, but eventually you'll have like a whole quest log basically inside this notebook.
Oh, so this is a log, like each page is logging a certain thing?
So this is basically right now what we're getting is a lot of like flavor text of her situation. So this page especially is like talking about how she actually isn't here for this body. She just happens to be in the town and then this body is there. So, so she's trying to get away from Agent Reyes. That stuff all comes into play later, but you'll also get eventually just like an actual quest log the way we did in the prologue where you just have like step-by-step directions of like, hey, these are the things that you actually need to get done, which is nice because in like those 90s point and clicks, it was really easy to just get lost and have no idea where you were supposed to be going.
Yeah.
Here, it's you pretty much always have an idea of what you should be doing next. Walked something odd. This might be the chainsaw.
There it is.
Just like in the middle of nowhere. Fool me twice. So yeah, she will
walk to Chainsaw of Disappointment.
It's pretty rusty.
What?
Totally out of chainsaw gas.
It's out of chainsaw gas, so
murder weapon. No missing body parts.
Just I like how an agent is just like picking up stuff around the crime scene. Yeah, no whatever.
That old tree is blocking great entrance.
What?
Someone in the sewer.
So this seems pretty campy. I mean,
it's definitely meant
it's
to
going
be.
For that.
Yeah. It's like a real silly, like the whole town. I mean, so we're going to get up to the sheriff here now. We've pretty much done everything we need to down here. The sheriff and the coroner are both like the same guy.
Yeah.
But they have different accents. And so they claim that they're different people.
All right.
It's real silly. There's also
Atari.
Yeah, there's a
ball blaster from Mucus Phlegm Games.
Oh,
so there's a company in this game called Mucus Phlegm,
okay,
which is a very thinly disguised parody of LucasArts.
Mucus
and so there's
phlegm.
A whole bunch of jokes about that later on. And later in the game, so like we have two characters right now. Later in the game, if I remember, we have five.
Oh wow.
So there's
at any given time or
so I'm only like in the middle of the next act. Signals are very but yeah, you have like there's a girl who wants to become a developer, and there's a clown who he's been cursed and he can't remove his makeup.
Nice.
And then there's a ghost later on, so
this is kind of giving me a Twin Peaks vibe.
Yeah, that's sort of what this whole vibe of this game is. Like, that's actually a really good touchstone for it.
Oh, okay.
Everybody has like that weird, like sort of off-kilter small town vibe.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, there's a place called Ricky's Pies, but she only sells vacuum tubes. And the whole town is like takes place in an alternate 1980s where transistors never became a thing and vacuum tubes took over. So,
oh, nice. All right.
Why brothers if you're sisters? Dad was expecting to have sons, and he was too cheap to have the van repainted. So we're just rolling with it till he's dead. Oh, soon. Shut up, Emily. Signals are very strong tonight. What signals? The signals.
How's the interplay between the two agents? Is it like an X-Files Scully and Mulder kind of thing, or
it's more dismissive than that? I think.
Oh, okay.
Like they really don't want to be around each other.
Oh.
Reyes is like the nicer of the two. Rey is like very cynical.
Mm.
And so, yeah, you can sort of like they pretty much have similar arcs, so you can pretty much just choose which one you want to play as, because you don't really get like a different story from them most of the time.
Well,
the way that they like talk to characters and stuff is usually like pretty similar because their relation with the characters in the town is very similar. But like the other characters will have like totally different relationships with those characters. So, for instance, like the clown is an insult comic. So almost all of your conversations with people in the town just start with him insulting them and then go from there. So you'll just like make fun of homeless people and stuff and make fun of a guy. There's a post office in town. And as your federal agent, you're like, you have like a normal relationship with the post office guy. Like he thinks that he's also a government agent, because he works for the post office.
Hmm.
And so he'll like try and help you out. But if you play as the clown, he'll just go in and like try and make the post office guy go nuts and shoot him.
This is really odd.
This is a good conversation too.
Designed to have no dead ends or death, yet still be scary and have a sense of tension. You can feel safe exploring whatever you want. But I'd watch out for the signals.
It's like a very, very like fourth wall breaking, like LucasArts jokes. Yeah, but playing classic adventure games taught me to save often.
Classic adventure games have taught me to save often. That was true up until Monkey Island.
Oh,
at least with LucasArts style adventures. Then the designers realized that death and dead ends weren't making the game more enjoyable. It was actually making it less fun.
Nice. So when there's other characters, if you're moving around between them, do the ones that you're not actively playing go and do something, or are they just waiting there?
Yeah, they just hang out. They hang out until you come back to them.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, you'll in some cases that actually is like related to puzzles. So at some point, and not to like spoil too much, but she gets trapped somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way to get her out is to bring the other agent over. And he has items that you need to like get out of the place that you're in.
Hmm.
And so like you end up playing both of them sort of like simultaneously, because you have to like navigate her into a position to wait for these items, and then navigate him to get the items, and then come back and put them in place. So, yeah, there's a lot of, I shouldn't say a lot, but there is some interplay between the two. But yeah, you can kind of just trade off whenever you want. I've normally been playing as Rey because she's like real dour about everything. So it's a lot of fun. But yeah, the game.
By the way, you're not supposed to shake Polaroid pictures. I'm sorry. That's,
yeah, it kills the. I found this out recently.
Yeah.
I also found out that like if you have real Polaroid film, you're supposed to like put that thing in like a dark place as soon as you take a picture to
I need that film. Yeah.
Which I never knew either, because normally you just see people take a picture and then like wave it in the air.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, back at the height of Polaroid film, not to go too deep down this, but the, you know, the developer actually was able to withstand light in a way that the kind of the new stuff like Impossible Project, like it's real sensitive for the first while, so which you can use in, you know, in creative ways anyway.
But yeah, here's our sheriff, and his accent is, he says Areno all the time.
Hard to miss the government issue suits.
So yeah, we're gonna we're pretty dismissive of the sheriff. Small town.
The river is so chock full of chemicals from the old pillow factory. It's better off there than in a tub of formaldehyde.
Pillow factory?
Yeah, the it plays a big part in the story.
Huh.
The pillow factory has burned down.
Ignore him. He's new.
No sense in wasting everyone's time, Reno. This cutscene is starting to get long, and it's only going to get longer. Let's find the coroner and get you on your
Speaking
way.
Of length, how long is the game?
I don't know. As I said, I'm like 4.5-5 hours in, and I feel like there's a lot to go, but I don't really know yet.
Huh.
We'll see.
Come see me when you're done. I apologize, Areno, for all the lights being off. We don't stay open as long as you city slickerinos do at night.
Even for a murder?
Especially for murder.
So yeah, kind of suspicious.
Are we authorized to shoot people Arenos?
One of my favorite things is you can use the water fountain, and all of your dialogue options are just dumb. And you can do it for a disturbing amount of time.
Yeah.
It just repopulates the conversation options forever. So I thought that it might be like an achievement or something for
to
messing
just
keep
with
going. This. So I clicked like 40 of them in a row the other day. Nothing.
Yep.
Just
okay.
Makes weird.
Just really, you're really thirsty.
Yep. And then you get like a good ah afterwards. So
okay.
I think we have to go to the coroner next, if I remember correctly. So yeah, same guy.
Thimbleweed Park coroner. Welcome to the future, who?
And his thing is, he says who?
Oh, I like the foreground. You know.
Yeah, with this nice tag on the toe.
Give a little depth to the scene.
Even for the Fedahoos.
Oh, do enlighten us.
I love your sarcastic humor, who, Agent Rey.
It's not humor.
There you go again. We're interested in any help.
So yeah, for what we're doing in Act 1, I think it's actually technically Act 2, but what we're doing in this section basically is we've got these three computers behind us, the Bloodtron, Fingertron, and Facetron. And each one of them, we have to match up basically like two pieces. So we have to get like a swab from the body and then a bloody item and put it in there and figure out like a match basically before we can arrest anybody. And same with the Fingertron and Facetron. You're just trying to find this evidence. But there's a lot of like walking around town trying to find the clues in very dumb ways. So
do you feel like an adventure game like this holds up in 2017?
I mean, so I think a lot of the 90s stuff doesn't hold up as well. Like, I think because a lot of that is like based around like pixel hunting and stuff, it doesn't play very well anymore.
And
I like a lot of that stuff is also very puzzle based, and like a lot of the puzzles are not very good, or they're just like silly and they kind of get in the way. I think the good thing about this game is it's like a very retro styled game, but it's definitely like modern. Like it is designed with modern audiences in mind.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of the puzzle, like I haven't gotten stuck really. I think I got stuck one time so far on a puzzle, and I'm playing on hard, which is like full puzzle mode.
Huh.
There's also a casual mode where he takes out some of the puzzles and like gives you more of just a story adventure. But I've been playing on hard, and even then I think I got stuck one time, and it was because I had just missed an object. So like, I think this particularly, if you haven't played a lot of LucasArts games, is still like a good game. Not only is it like a funny game, but it also like is not a very, I don't know, like it's not an unintuitive adventure. You can still like get through it pretty easily. And yeah, it's just the writing is, I think like all the characters in this game are pretty damn good.
Nice. Isn't it kind of interesting, you know, one of the last things we looked at was Torment,
yeah.
You know,
and
now this coming out, yep. You know, do you think 2017's the, could have a big resurgence?
I mean, so like, I really would like to see him, license this engine out and like give it to other people to make stuff like this, because it like comes out really nice and
yeah, it is pretty,
it is like a really cool type of adventure game that we don't get anymore.
Yeah.
Like we really just get the standard, like Double Fine style or Telltale style, like those types of adventure games, which are very like context driven, and there aren't like a lot of like hidden jokes for you to find by like combining dumb items or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
This one has a lot of that. But yeah, so the fun thing about this running gag with the sheriff in the corner is like everybody you talk to will say the same dumb line about like, oh, there's some resemblance around the eyes. I have paperwork to do. Oh, yeah, almost forgot. These Tron machines are fully voice activated, so if you need any information, just talk to them. It's like we're living in the futuristic year of 2017. Nice. Yeah, there's some good references to the current year also. Let's investigate these Tron
machines, then go see the sheriff. You just walk away.
Yeah, we're not even going to do that. We're just going to go see the sheriff. And then... Hello again, Agent Arenos.
Hopefully the coroner fills you in on our state of the art. Donuts. Now I just want some donuts.
You're also the coroner, right? Oh, my, no. Ha, ha. No,
Areno. People say there is some resemblance around the eyes, but we're as different as peas arenos in a pot areno. Plus, the coroner has that annoying ahoo he adds to everything. You'll never hear me doing that, areno.
Is literally word for word the same exact speech the coroner gives you, except it says areno on everything.
That's pretty good.
It's really... Yeah, I don't know. There's a lot of really smart writing in this game.
And that's why you come to it, right? You know.
Yeah, like that's the thing, is like a lot of those 90s adventure games have really good stories, but like you get caught up in the puzzle stuff, and that stuff is not as much fun.
Trying to get to them.
This one is like very focused on just like telling you a good story, and then like there's a couple puzzles in there that are related, like, oh, it's you light a log on fire with some hot sauce or whatever. That's like very like it's throwback type puzzles, but they're a lot less, I don't know, obtuse than 90s puzzles were, which were often like 12 steps and like all of them were impossible.
And is what they said earlier true? Like there's no dead ends, no death.
None that I've hit. There have even been a couple things where somebody has said like, if this was a Sierra game, I would have died there. Luckily.
Nice.
Should we investigate Chuck as a suspect? And yeah, this is the first time Chuck comes up. Chuck is a mysterious character that you'll learn more about later.
Huh.
He's like a town hero, but nobody wants to talk about him.
Thimbleweed County. We'll talk more about Chuck later. I need to run a Reno and check on a disturbance call out at the old circus.
Probably that stupid clown Reno again. And that's... obviously, the guy who we're gonna play as later.
Nice.
So yeah, we're gonna wrap this up in a second. We're gonna walk outside and make things go
faster. If we follow agency questioning protocols, this shouldn't take long.
Just don't mess anything up. I want to get out of here as fast as possible.
Agreed. Their heads are very large.
Yes, they're very 90s style. Anyways, we will walk down the street over here.
Oh, whoops. Those pigeons again.
Yeah, so as you can see, there's a vacuum tube on top of the fire hydrant.
Oh, that's how it works, huh?
Yeah, so you'll have to replace that later. Empty town for the most part. And then we'll come over to this alleyway.
Is that a hand? Oh, it's a mannequin. Okay. Wait.
And so, yeah, that's where we're going to wrap. That's Thimbleweed Park. Comes out next week. By the time you see this, it'll be out, I think.
Nice.
And yeah, I think it's really strong. I mean, we can now, as you see, we only have one character. Uh-oh. So
the mystery continues.
Yeah. So yeah, this is, as I said, Ron Gilbert and co making a very Ron Gilbert type 90s adventure game. And I think the writing is really smart. Maybe that'll change. Maybe it'll all fall apart at the end. But as I said, I'm like 4.5 hours in and I've laughed more at this game. Like I've actually laughed out loud, like not just done the the breathing heavily. Yeah. And I've actually laughed out loud at this game a couple of times, which is usually a very rare thing. I think that comedy in games is usually very hard to nail.
Yeah.
And this one is very, very good at it. So, look for that.
Awesome. Cool. Thanks, Hayden.
Yeah, thank you, Adam.